Hiya. So this is how I play Sweet Painted Lady by Elton John. I play it with a capo on the third fret, using the chords in the key of D. So the concert key would be F. About everything I talk about will be in the key of D, counting the capo as the zero fret. So we start in a D. And the kind of picking that I'm doing is just it's a sort of a strum, but I'm picking occasional strings. That kind of thing. So it's not really anything specific that I'm doing. It's just, you know, play whatever sensitivity you sort of like, but it's basically a strum and a, that kind of thing. So it comes in straight on, back on dry land once again, which is a D in a normal position. And then it switches to a D major 7, which is, I use my first finger, barred first three strings on the second fret. So effectively what you've done is you've taken that D note on the second string and you've lowered it by half a tone to a C sharp. Back on dry land once again. Yeah. Then the next chord is a D7. Which is, again, you've taken that C sharp on the second fret and lowered it to a C. So you've got... Yep. Next chord is a D, is a G major. Then a G minor. But to get a G minor, put a bar on the third fret. Put your third finger on the fifth string, fifth fret, and put your fourth finger on the fourth string, fifth fret. You're effectively playing an E minor chord shape with a bar on the third fret. Then D. And all I'm doing there is lifting my finger off the first string and then putting it back on again. Next chord is an E minor 7, which is just one finger on the fifth string, second fret. And then I'm also adding in the other part of that, which is also an E minor 7, it's just a different way to play it. You play also with your fourth finger or your third finger, the second string on the third fret. So that D note there. So that's an E minor 7 with just one finger. That's an E minor 7 with the extra finger fretted in there, and it has the effect of... So what I'm doing is picking the first string, then the second string, and you get that kind of descending. Then the next chord is an A7, which you're familiar with. It's first finger, second fret, fourth string, second finger, second fret, second string. And then the last chord. Okay, so what I've done is I've taken that E note on the second fret and I'm playing with my third finger, I put it down on the fourth string on the third fret, which is, it's kind of an A augmented. It's adding that, that's the E note is the fifth note of the A major scale, and you're playing the sharp fifth note. So if you played that with an A major and the sharp fifth, that's an A augmented, but I'm sort of adding the augmented, the sharp fifth, to the seventh chord. And then back to the D. Okay, so it goes, I'm back on dry land once again. Let me get the words. I'm back on dry land once again. Opportunity awaits me like a rat in a drain. We're all hunting honey with money to burn. Now all I'm doing on that G chord, taking my finger off and hammering it back on the fifth string, then doing that on the fourth string, second fret. That all works in that G chord. Okay, I'm back on dry land once again. Opportunity awaits me like a rat in a drain. We're all hunting honey with money to burn. Just a short time to show you the tricks that we've learned. If the boys all behave themselves here, this pretty young lady's beer in the rear. You won't need a gutter to sleep in tonight. The prices we charge you will see you alright. Then there's a third verse, and then to get into the chorus again, the A augmented. And then you go to a D. Sweet painted. Then the next chord is just a half a tone lower than that. Lady. So it's a C sharp. And what I'm doing there, putting a bar on the fourth fret, and then I'm playing an A chord, which is my, on the sixth fret, fourth string, sixth fret, third string, sixth fret, second string. And I tend to play that with just one finger, which so I break my knuckle, if you like, if you can see that. But if you can see the angle that I've put my knuckle at, I can use my little finger to do it, or I can use my third finger to do it. So I'm playing just the second, third, and fourth strings. And because my knuckle is bent, the first string is still being played just by my index finger with the bar. So the first chord, D. Sweet painted, C sharp, lady. And then another one down. Seems it's always been, so that's a C chord. You could do that with an open shape. I just do it because I'm here for the C sharp. I just move everything back a half a tone, put the bar on the third fret, play it there. And then the next chord is a B7, and you can play that on the second fret with the bar, and then the A7 shape on the fourth fret, or you can play it in its normal, where you've got that second string, fifth fret, sorry, fifth string, second fret, fourth string, first fret, third string, second fret, first string, second fret. Okay, so you've got D, sweet painted, C sharp, lady, C, seems it's always been, B7, the same. E minor 7, getting paid, A7, for being laid, D. Guess that's the name of the A7 game. Whoa! And then you repeat that again. Sweet painted lady, seems it's always been the same. Getting paid for being laid. Guess that's the name of the game. Whoa. Forget us, we'll have gone there soon. Just forget we ever slept in your room. We'll leave the smell of the sea in your bed. Where love's just a job and nothing is said. Oh, sweet painted lady, seems it's always been the same. That's the name of the game. Oh, sweet painted lady, seems it's always been the same. Getting paid for being late, guess that's the name of the game. Oh. Then to outro, I just do the chord sequence in half the time. So half a bar of each instead of one bar. So, very simple, really nice. More or less what he plays on the record, but, you know, who's counting the differences? Have fun.